Hello guys, welcome to the channel. In this video, we are going to have a look at aTrain, which is a tool for automatically transcribing speech recordings utilizing state-of-the-art machine learning models without uploading any data. This tool was developed by researchers at the Business Analytics and Data Science Center at the University of Graz and tested by researchers from the NO Center Graz. If you don't know where Graz is, it is one of the most beautiful places on the earth. And these are few of the images from Graz. It is in Austria, which I believe is one of the top three countries when it comes to the beauty in Europe, hands down. Anyway, so this project is originating from Graz, so must be good. Let's see. We will be installing it locally and then we will play around with it. The good thing is that this tool is equally compatible with Windows. You can even install it from your Windows App Store, but we will be installing it in the Linux Ubuntu system because that is what have been sponsored by our good friends at Mast Compute, who are not only sponsoring this Ubuntu system, but also they have very graciously given us the GPU to run a lot of other things. If you're looking to rent GPU on affordable prices, I will drop the link to their website in video description. Plus, I'm also going to give you a coupon code of 50% discount on a range of GPUs. Okay, coming back to aTrain. So this project has been based on a very finely written paper called as Take the aTrain, which you can access it from their GitHub repo, and I will drop the link to it in video description. And as I mentioned earlier, Windows 10, Windows 11, it will work. Ubuntu, it will work. It is quite fast and accurate system, and it provides a user-friendly access to the faster Whisper implementation of OpenAI's Whisper model, and it ensures best-in-class transcription quality paired with higher speed on your local computer. Transcription when selecting the highest quality model takes only around 3 times the audio length on current mobile CPU typically found in the run-of-the-mill notebooks like Core i5 12th Gen, Ryzen series 6000, and so on and so forth. It also enables you to do speaker detection. So in that one, you can easily analyze each text segment to determine which speaker the audio belongs to. And then there are a lot of other good features too, which you can read through their repo, like it is GDPR compliance. Of course, it is originating from Europe, and GDPR is a big thing there for privacy preservation. It has a multilingual support, by the way, so it's not just English. It is supporting languages across the globe, including some of the regional languages like Tamil in India, Tagalog in India, or African languages, which is great, like Afrikaans from South Africa and parts of other countries of that continent, Swahili, and then some of various European languages. It also supports Urdu from Pakistan, Welsh, Turkish, Thai, Portuguese, Korean, Latvian, German, French, Azerbaijani, and lot of other great languages like Arabic, Armenian, English, Estonian, and the list goes on and on. So really good stuff there. Okay, enough talk. Let me take you to the terminal and then we will get started by installation. You can see that I'm running Ubuntu 22.04 LTS, and this is my NVIDIA card, which is RTX 6000. With 48 GB of VRAM, but I believe you can even run it with 24 GB of VRAM in L4 or even lesser. I have seen people running these sort of things on CPU too. Okay, so let me clear the screen. Let me create a Conda environment, and I'm just calling it aTrain. Let's wait for it to finish. Shouldn't take too long, and then we will proceed further. And you can see that it's already created and activated. One of the prerequisites is that you must ensure that you have FFmpeg library installed, and this is how you install it in Ubuntu, and I believe you can similarly very easily install it on other operating system including Windows. So you see it is already installed. It is a multimedia library which is commonly used for video audio encoding, decoding, and transcoding, and you can see that we already have it installed, so which is all good. And now let's install this aTrain from source, from its GitHub. Plus we are also giving it a PyTorch version just to install with it in our Conda environment. So let me run it. It is going to install it after cloning. Let's wait for it to finish. It is going to take a fair bit of time, so let's be patient and wait for it to finish. It took a fair bit of time, but it has finished installing all the prerequisites. Let me clear the screen here and let's proceed further. And now we will be initializing this aTrain. And initializing means that we need this aTrain to download all the necessary models for transcription and speaker detection. And this only has to be done once when installing it. So let's run it. And you see that as soon as I ran that aTrain init, it is downloading all the models. So let's wait for it to get finished. It's still downloading the models. So all the models have been downloaded. Took a bit of a time. Let's clear the screen. And now in order to run this aTrain, all you need to do is to just run aTrain start, and it is going to start it in your browser. So let's wait for it to open it in the browser. So if you just click behind it, there you go. So our aTrain is already running in the browser, and how good the interface looks. Really amazing. Now the interface is very, very intuitive. As you can see, it does transcription offline, and that is what you get the feel from this interface. So first you can select any file from here. So for example, if I go to my home page, I already have a few of the sample files here. So I'm just going to go into my files folder. Maybe I'll just select my own WAV file. Let's check it out. I think most audio video formats are allowed. That is good. And then from here, you can select different models, and that is why it loaded all of these models earlier. You can go with the fastest, tiniest, or medium accurate, and then even the most accurate large V2. I'm just going to go with medium accurate, and I will let it detect the language automatically. Otherwise, you can also help him out. And I'm not, because it's just my own, so I don't want to do the speaker detection. And let's click on start here. So running on GPU, that is great. Let's wait for it. And by the way, as per their repo in Linux, they mostly prefer CPU. So on Windows, it more towards GPU. But anyway, let's wait for it to finish. And there you go. So it has finished transcribing. It is telling me that it just finished in 9 seconds. Which is good. And then let's open the folder where our transcription is. Oh wow, okay, there is a lot of stuff. So let me open this transcription.txt. yep, that is cool. That is, I just created this random file with my text, so that is cool. Let's try out now a bit longer file. So I'm just going to keep it as is. I'll just close this. I'll say back. Now let me select another file. So I'm just going to select 1 minute file now. And then maybe I'll go with most accurate, and I'll say let's detect it automatically. Let's wait for it. It is going well. Let's wait for it. And it again, very, very quick. Let's open it. Let's open this txt file. And there you go. So 1 minute transcription, it did it in 9 seconds again. And if I quickly see it, yep, that is cool. But what is this Soviet? That is, I think that is not correct. But other than that, looks good to me. The gist is fine. Okay, cool. Okay, now let's try out one more. So I'm just going to select one of the sample files which is provided by aTrain. And then maybe I'll just switch on this multi one, and I will detect it automatically. Okay, you can even specify it yourself. So let's start it. And it is giving us some estimated time. Let's wait for it to finish. And there you go. So it again finished it. Let's open it. Took around 31 seconds. So if I open this, oh wow, amazing. Look how much the text is. And it just took 31 seconds to transcribe it. And if I quickly read through it, looks quite good to me. So all in all, really very fine tool, really like it. and especially the interface and the way it is working. And best of all, it is all open source and run offline locally after downloading the model. You don't have to give any OpenAI key or anything like that. So that's it, guys. Let me know what do you think. I will drop the link to it in video description, and I will also drop all the commands which I have used in my blog, and I will drop the link in video description. If you like the content, please consider subscribing to the channel. If you're already subscribed, please share it among your network, as it helps a lot. Thanks for watching.